Hey everyone, this is NIKKO, and for this painting I wanted to show how to use Procreate Pocket 3.0 to create a complex landscape painting on your phone, even if you're on a bus. And just for the record, when painting this, most of the time I was in a bus when I was going to teach at the school. I'm teaching concept art sometimes for video game students, and during those trips I was painting this piece. When I started painting, I didn't really have a clear plan of what I wanted to do, but I wanted to do some kind of an airship. So in the beginning, I had only two layers at this point. One for the sky and the green background of the grass, and then one for the entire airship. It's just blobs of color, because I know that I won't be using any of this for the final painting. It's just planning of where all the areas of color and values are going. And generally, I just wanted to figure out the silhouette of the ship. And for that, I also pressed on the perspective guide. And then with the drawing assist on, I added these like vertical walls on the left and right side of the airship to kind of have an idea of how the perspective affects the silhouette of the ship, because the painting is so vertical that I need to keep interest throughout the top of the painting as well, so I can't have the vanishing point be too severe. For the design of this piece or the ship, I wanted it to be kind of clumsy looking, because it's a greenhouse with lots of trees and plants in it. I want it to look like it can't move fast, that it's kind of like a slow moving, like more like gliding type of movement that this ship does. So I wanted that kind of like weight to be part of the entire design. And I wanted this event of like the character in the foreground seeing this painting, I wanted it to feel like a rare event, like in Ghibli's Howling Castle, like when the castle walks by, it always looks like that doesn't happen every day, that it's kind of like a rare occurrence. I know that this painting has a lot of like Ghibli-esque colors, and I love Ghibli movies, but mostly it's inspired by late 90s video games and stuff like, for example, Skies of Arcadia. I love the airships in that. I love airships in general, and Final Fantasy IX is one of my favorite games of all time, and I just love the art direction in that as well. And I wish there were more like that these days. So I just like doing these paintings. I'd like to see worlds like this in modern video games with the current budgets and the graphical fidelity of the video games, but I can dream in a way that I can make paintings like this, so it's fine. Now you see me adding like more layers to the sky to have one for the clouds, and the way I keep shuffling the clouds is that I want there to be contrast in the areas that draws attention towards the airship itself. So I'm placing the white clouds near the white sails on the edges of the painting. So when the vertical and diagonal lines are kind of leading the eye out of the painting, I stop that movement by adding a cloud there, and it destroys the contrast and creates more contrast towards the center of interest in this painting. For all of the details, I start adding more and more layers that where I just like draw in the details using the drawing assist and perspective guide to create those like horizontal wooden lines and windows to the ship. And when the sharp details are there, I always flatten them on the surface of the ship, because I want to keep the number of layers as low as possible. So I need to have these elements finished, and then I need to commit to them by flattening them down. Here you see me doing a single window for the foreground, and then I just like copy the row of windows and then adjust them by transforming them to match the perspective guides. And That way it looks like there's a lot of sharp detail, even though I just needed to make one window. And then when the windows are in place, I hand paint like lighting effects on top of them to make them look more individual and like part of the ship. And there's going to be these like windmill-like blades on the side of the ship. And there I repeat the same process, that I just do one single blade with the quick shape. And with the quick shape, I'm able to get that sharp corners of the square right. And after that, I just duplicate the layer and rotate it 90 degrees and merge it down and rotate it 180 degrees. And then I get this like cross-like blade. And when that sharp shape is done, I just copy it three times, and then with that row of blades, I adjust it with the perspective grid to the side of the ship. So it looks like all of them match in scale. And once they are in place, I hit Alpha Lock on the layer, and then I finally add the lighting effects on these white plates, so that they look like the sun is hitting them only on the side where the sun is visible. All of the details themselves, they are not that difficult to do, because I have that kind of like blobs of color underneath, so I know what kind of detail I want to be in each part. So that way I can like break down these details into these smaller chunks that I just work on one area until it matches the plan, and then I move onwards. All of these green parts, these bushes and trees on the side of the airship, they're on their separate layer, so they won't be like messing with my geometric looking lines beneath. For all the white sails type of structures here, I use Alpha Lock, and then I add this kind of like softer additive brush strokes on top of them that I blur into the surface so that it looks like a subsurface scattering lighting effect. But it's a very, very slight low opacity type of effect, because the white sails need to read white. So even the dark parts are only slightly darker than the white areas. Because even at this stage, I'm still avoiding any part of the painting to going white, and same with the shadows, that I don't want any part of the painting to be black. And the reason for that is that I want to keep enough values so that there is a bit of like wiggle room for final color adjustments in the end. As you see that the final piece is quite saturated and it's very bright, and it does go to those bright highlights. But at the same time, I have adjusted all the colors to kind of match the mood of the piece. And to have that kind of like adjustment room in the painting, I need to avoid all whites and blacks, because nothing can be whiter than white or blacker than black. So those are just not part of my palette at this point. The way I adjust colors is that I copy everything into a single layer, and then I set that to overlay mode. And then that overlay layer on top of everything, I adjust the curves so that it's almost completely gray. So there in the curves panel, that line is almost horizontal. The horizontal line is the gray area of the colors, so that anything that is slightly lighter gets exponentially lighter, and anything that is darker gets more dark from that point onwards. So the overlay layer can be almost completely gray. The curves adjustment can be very slight, and I always use that at low opacity, and it just pushes those colors to the direction and temperature that I want to and I use the different color channels to like make those final tweaks. And this is the painting called Flying Greenhouse. I hope this process has helped you to figure out similar kind of complex issues in your landscape paintings, and I hope you subscribe and hit the bell button and press all the buttons, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye!